disclaimer. If you guys do not want to see me get frustrated, because I'm going to get really mad. I get really mad trying that back 180, or, well, skating the little step thing behind me over here. If you guys do not want to see me get frustrated, skip this part of the video. Otherwise, this is literally the realest me you're going to see. I'm not saying like I get frustrated all the time I skate, because I really don't, but I just want to give you guys that fair warning. I get really mad during this skating this two-step or whatever the heck, this little drop over here. I get really frustrated. So if you guys are not trying to see me get that frustrated or slam or whatever I had going on, skip that part. Skip this next part of the video. I'll have a timestamp right here. Give you a couple seconds to do so. All right, so if you don't want to skip it, try to find enjoyment of it. And just understand that I'm human too. I don't land things all the time. I'm not a perfect skater, and I do struggle. And I'm gonna cut it down because it's literally 22 minutes of me getting frustrated trying to skate that. Enjoy.
Been able to hold gaps for a minute, man. I landed. I was in those orange DC West Kramers, so I'm feeling like it was 2019, but I could be wrong. But I literally haven't been able to back 180 down something since. Like, of course, like curbs and stuff, but for some reason, when it's higher than one little thing, it starts acting up. Of course, I put my hand on the roughest part of the park. It stinks so much because it's already cold. Oh man. I don't know why I'm even frustrated this session. Like, this isn't even something I've done the first try or anything. It's like getting frustrated out of nowhere. And that's the worst thing about it, I'm frustrated. And it's not even me thinking about skateboarding. Like, yeah, I'm a little upset that I missed some trick and slamming. Oof. Now I'm frustrated. Like, it's not even like me, like, I'm mad that I can't land everything first try. It's just, I'm frustrated. and I can't even pinpoint why I'm frustrated all of a sudden. Like, me trying these tricks and stuff and trying to get more footage started it, but it's not the reason I'm still frustrated. I mean, that just pissed me off. Like, I just went from like 6 to 10 so fast. Average person is probably thinking at this point, why are you even still trying it? It's frustrating you so bad. It's just adding to how mad you are. And it's simply because it's something that I know I can do. You guys have seen me stick majority of them. I know I can do it. And every single time I attempt this trick, every time I've attempted backbending down something, I have it roll away from it, not even sketchy. And I continuously walk away from it knowing that I can do it. And that is one of the most frustrating things in skateboarding, I'm not gonna lie. It's like knowing you could fix your car, you have the resources, everything, and you don't fix your car. So then your car continues to drive bad and you think, damn, I should have fixed my car. It's literally just like that. And that's what makes me so upset about it. But that is still only half of my frustration right now. Ah! And then there's that. I don't want to be mad, man.
So yeah, that was that. I don't know what it is, and it irritates me every single time, like literally to the point where I don't even want to skate for the rest of the day, but I'm not gonna let that happen to me today. I don't want one experience out of my day to ruin the rest of my day. Although, like I was saying while I was skating that, the frustration isn't even 100% in the back 180 today. I've been really off all month, honestly, for the last 2 months, I've been very off, and I've only talked out with a couple of people who I really trust, like my girl, my close friends, stuff like that. And eventually, we'll have to talk to you guys about it, because I feel like that's just the right thing to do. And I feel like, of course, me talking out like something that's going on in my life and something that frustrates me and, you know, things I don't understand and working through it for you guys on YouTube might help you guys work through something that's frustrating you. So that's why I showed that struggle That's why I talked about how it's not even just a trick, because 100%, guys, as frustrated as I was getting, as I was missing and slipping out and slamming, that has not been my full frustration. There has been literally something going on in the back of my mind for these past couple of months, and it's like it just needs a trigger to then start invading into my day, and I've been trying to work that out. But anywho, back to the back 180. I don't know, like, it really frustrates me with that one, because it's something that I've tried time and time and time again, literally since I got it in 2019, and I have not been able to do it since, get close or anything. And when Andrew filmed me back in 2019, I think it was 2019, it could be 2019 or 2020. If I'm saying 2019 and it's 2020, I'm gonna put it down here one time when I say it, or as many times as I do say it, I don't know, it depends how hard I want to edit this. But I think it was 2019 for sure, because I just don't remember having the DC West Kramers in 2020. But literally ever since I've tried that trick, since that time rolling away at Brook Run doing it, I haven't been able to do it. And it's crazy, because I did that so fast at Brook Run. I think, if I'm correct, and if Andrew sees this video, he might reach out to me and correct me if he remembers, but I'm pretty sure it was less than 10 tries and I got it. And I did two sketchy ones, or I did a sketchy one. I remember doing a sketchy one and having to clean it up, but I don't know what it was. Maybe it was just a thinner shoe and, like, I don't know, it sticks to the board better, I feel it out better or something. But literally, I've been struggling with it since. A lot of people have been telling you, you know, you need to squat and you need to stay, like, bend your knees and stuff like that. I promise you, whether it looks like it or not, I definitely do. And that's how I end up falling back every time. Like, if I don't bend my knees, I'd fall forward, or I would just shock and bounce off or something of that nature. Literally, I bend my knees every single time and I end up literally sitting back. And I don't know what it is about back 180, but I always do that and it frustrates me. And then there's the times where I don't fully rotate. It's really frustrating when it's a trick that you could do daily, and, like, you know, you do back, like, I do back 180s, flat ground, up stuff, on the things, whatever the case may be. I do it all the time. And for some reason, it's just been very, very hard. And not to mention, it's cold. So when I fall, it hurts more, especially on my hands, which I'm now starting to feel again, but wasn't really feeling that much throughout the session. But anywho, I don't want to bum you guys out with this session. So, I don't know. It happens like that. But, I mean, with that being said, I mean, I tried to get it. I can't even speak. Ah, man. I'm literally still that frustrated. I'm going to end the video here, guys. I am sorry that I wasn't able to get it. Hopefully, I'm able to tell you guys soon a little bit more of what's going on as I learn. Like, oh my God, I can't even think straight. But yeah, I hope to reach out to you guys on, not reach out. I hope to let you guys know soon, like, what's been going on, as soon as I can figure it out and start working through it. I don't know. I just feel like there's a lot of pressure in my life right now. And, like, you know, every decision I make isn't just my decision. And it hasn't ever really just been something where I could just be like, all right, let me make this decision for me. It always involves other people. It always affects other people. And it's been weighing on me a lot harder than it has been before. But it has nothing to do with YouTube. It's not like I'm going to take a hiatus from YouTube or anything like that. If I do, I will let you guys know in the community tab if I don't make a video about it. But it literally has nothing to do with you guys. It's just everything else going on in life. And it's one of the main things that's prevented me from doing a day in the life type videos since, and, you know, just, I don't know, being as communicative with you guys as I know I could be, and I've seen other YouTubers do. But I'm gonna try harder. I'm gonna try not to let this take over my life and stuff like that, and I'm gonna do what I can to still impress you guys. Not impress you guys, because, I mean, I want to impress myself too. But I'm gonna do what I can to bring out the best content for you guys. And 100%, I'm gonna keep it real with you guys throughout my sessions and even throughout my shoe reviews and whatever, just because I don't want you guys to come here thinking that I'm just another YouTuber trying to make views. Because although I am trying to make views, I want to keep it real with you guys, because that's what's gonna make the session you know, a good session, and that's what's gonna make you guys coming to my page, you know, much more authentic and stuff like that. So with that being said, for today I'm gonna say a little bit differently. If you guys like the video, feel free to leave a like. I'm not telling you to leave a like. If you guys want to subscribe to me, hopefully see me get through this rut, and I'm gonna explain a little bit more, so I know I could help somebody with going through my own situations and letting you guys know and giving vulnerability on the fact that I'm not 100% okay, and I haven't been for the past couple of months. But outside of that, if you guys just want some good content and just want some realness coming from another YouTuber, definitely hit the subscribe button. It means a lot to me. 2,000 of you guys did it, and it's so sick. I think I'm at 2,080 subscribers, and I wanted to make a video so bad about hitting 2,000 subs, and it happened literally during the first month of me struggling my ass off with what's been going on. So, and once again, I still don't fully know what's been frustrating me this hardcore, but it's a lot. Anywho, thank you guys for watching this video. It really does mean a lot to me. And enjoy the rest of your day. Feel free to check out the rest of my videos. They'll pop up somewhere around here. And peace out. Have a great day, guys.